हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम बिनीता गुप्ता, अ टीचर ट्रेनी ऑफ सिलीगुड़ी तराई बीएड कॉलेज एंड सिलीगुड़ी प्राइमरी टीचर्स ट्रेनिंग कॉलेज। सो हियर टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू अ चैप्टर फ्रॉम पॉलिटिकल साइंस व्हिच इज कम्स अंडर वेस्ट बंगाल बोर्ड ऑफ क्लास 12। सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू एन इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक दैट इज द डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन फंडामेंटल राइट्स एंड डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ द स्टेट पॉलिसी। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग आई वुड लाइक टू गिव यू अ शॉर्ट इंट्रोडक्शन ऑन फंडामेंटल राइट्स एंड डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ द स्टेट पॉलिसी। नाउ व्हाट इज फंडामेंटल राइट्स? फंडामेंटल राइट्स आर एसेंशियली ह्यूमन राइट्स दैट्स ऑफर टू ऑल द सिटीजन इरेस्पेक्टिव ऑफ क्लास, क्रेड, race, place of birth, religious or gender. As we already know that in our Indian constitution we have altogether 6 fundamental rights. Right to equality comes under article 14 to 18. Number 2, right to freedom comes under article 19 to 22. Number 3, right against exploitations. It comes under article 23 to 24. Now, next, cultural and educational rights. It comes under article 25 to 28. Now, next, right to freedom of religious. It comes under article 29 to 30. And the last fundamental rights is rights to constitutional remedies. It comes under Article 32. Initially, there are 7 fundamental rights in our Indian Constitution. But right to property was later converted into legal rights by the 44th amendment of the constitution in 1978. Now, what is directive principle of the state policy? Directive principle of the state policy are nothing but the guidelines to the center and the state governments of India to keep in the mind while framing the laws or policies. Okay, directive principles of the state policy comes under part 4 of the Indian constitution, and the main point is it is not justiciable, it is not enforceable by any courts of law. Okay, now move on. Differences between fundamental rights and directive principle of the state policy. Number one point is concept. Fundamental rights are borrowed from the American Constitution, whereas directive principles of the state policy is borrowed from the Irish Constitution. It is also known as the philosophical parts of the Indian Constitution. Okay, now number two point is content. Fundamental rights comes under part 3 of the Indian constitution, whereas directive principles of the state policy, it comes under part 4 of the Indian constitution. Number three point is articles. Fundamental rights comes under article 12 to 35, whereas directive principles of the state policy, it comes under article 36 to 51. Now, number four point is aims and objectives. The main aims and objectives of the fundamental rights is to guarantee few basic rights to the citizen as well as non-citizen. Here we can take an example, right to life. In this world, each and every person have rights to live, isn't it? Now, next, directive principle of the state policy. The main aim of directive principle of the state policy is to make a welfare state. Here, welfare state means to protect and to promote the economic and social well-beings of the citizens. Okay. Now, the last point is nature. Fundamental rights are justiciable and it is enforceable by any courts of law. Okay. Whereas directive principles of the state policy are not justiciable. It is not enforceable by any courts of law. Now, the big question, that is why fundamental rights are called justiciable. In fundamental rights, they are articles from 12 to 35. If anyone infringes the fundamental rights, that time we can directly approach to the Supreme Court and High Court. Okay. If anyone infringes the fundamental rights, we can directly approach to the Supreme Court and High Court. Okay. In India, we can directly approach to the Supreme Court and High Court by Article 32. For that reason, it is justiciable and it is enforceable by any courts of law. Okay. Now, why directive principle of the state policy are not justiciable? Because I already told you that directive principle of the state policy has the main aim, that is to make a welfare state, to promote and to protect economic and social well-beings of the citizen, isn't it? For that reason, it is not justiciable. It is not enforceable by any courts of law. Okay, this much for today. I hope you can understand the differences between fundamental rights and directive principles of the state policy. If you have any doubt, so please comment me and please like my video. Thank you.